and I'm looking fine.
Them old shoes ain't got no shine.
I'm going to the track and I'm gonna win a ton.
Been about a year since the last time you won.
I got this horse, he come off the pace.
Five will give you 10, he ain't in the race.
The horse looks good and he can do.
The last time he won was in 42.
I bet a song I can do to my sister's band.
What's this horseshoe say gonna win?
I got the long shot.
What long shot?
The long shot.
The long shot?
The long shot. I talked to the jock and he say it's a lock.
The horse a lock? Who told the jock?
The shoe told me this horse can fly.
You sure this shoe's a reliable guy?
I tell you this horse gonna win by five.
I tell you that's a lot of jive.
This horse gonna win going away.
I say we bust by the end of the day.
I bet a song about the deuce of my sister's pen.
What makes you so sure this horse gonna win?
Got the long shot.
What long shot?
Long shot.
The long shot.
The long shot.
The last time that horse run, he run wide.
That's cause a jock give him a bum ride.
He broke flat-footed, stumbled at the gate.
Get your money on the nose before it's too late.
Don't waste your money on some old nag.
Don't you believe there's money in the bag?
My money's on the chalk and that is that.
Horse win, you're gonna eat my hat. I'm gonna tell you once, I'm gonna tell you twice. This is better than throwing them dice. This horse is ready and looking slick. He got the speed, he got the stick. This horse is good and that's the truth. You can even ask my sister Ruth.
You're tapped out, Mr. Muckenmire.
He'll be in front when he hits a wire. I know this horse is gonna win. I bet it's all about the deuce of my sister's pen. And a long shot.
What long shot?
The long shot.
The long shot.
Here, you better come out.
Let's everybody stand back.
This is your last chance. We're coming in.
Did he take your wallet?
Worse than that.
Come on, fella, lighten up now. Now, what's he done?
I ain't done nothing.
What's he done? I'll tell you what he's done. This son of a bitch has eliminated any chance I had of winning this race by not letting me in my lucky toilet. That's what he's done.
Officer, I think I can handle it. See, he's a little superstitious, and before he makes a bet, he likes to go in his lucky toilet.
And this guy won't let me in.
Is that it?
Pretty much so, officer, yeah.
Come on, let's go, come on.
Wait a minute. This is my lucky stall. I don't have a snowball chance of hell in winning this race if I don't get to take a link and toss a penny in a pot.
It has worked before, officer.
I'm telling you, let's move it. Come on, come on. Well, let's just get moving it. Come on. Come on, let's get out of here.
I hope your ass falls off.
Up yours.
Hey, what do you think?
What are you doing? Can't you just say, what do you think? You have to say, what do you think?
Look at this. What do you think?
I think we bet on 8 races and we haven't cashed 1 ticket. I think we're in trouble. That's what I think. Look what you did.
You know, you shouldn't be eating those things anyway. You know what's in hot dogs? I read it in the paper.
What?
Lips.
What?
Yeah, lips. They hack them off, grind them up, and put them right in the dog.
You mean lips?
No. Mmm, lips.
I said.
Where have you guys been?
Somebody's in his lucky crack.
What?
Yeah, you know, he can't make a bet unless he goes down to the old porcelain wishing well.
That's stupid. That's got nothing to do with winning.
Yeah, well, he thinks it's right.
You're right, I'm right. And the track knows all the stuff that's going on. I mean, you got a rhythm going, they'll do anything to screw you up. I'll tell you, You take a lucky leak in a stall four times in a row, you win four races in a row. You go down the fifth time, I guarantee you, there's going to be guys standing there in the stall taking a leak till the next race is over. And if you really look into it, you find this guy's working for the track.
I find it difficult to believe that a multi-million dollar business has got a team of guys out looking for lucky pissers.
Yeah, well, they do.
Oh, jeez, I forgot to feed Ollie.
We're on death row here, and he's worried about feeding some stupid goldfish. Why don't you leave him a bowl of lips?
Hey, that fish ain't stupid. He actually watches TV.
How do you know that?
Because I watch him. That fish will stay in one position for a whole hour when Love Boat is on. I think he likes it because it has to do with water.
Rocket scientist.
Come on, guys. Got any hunches here? Josh, what do you got here?
I like the three horse.
Three's a pig.
Well, what the hell you asked me for?
Because we were thinking about the five.
Okay. I like the five horse.
You can't bet on the five. He's got Sanchez on him.
Do you believe this lard ass?
What about the four horse?
No time to joke around.
What joke? The four horse is 60 to 1.
Yeah, there's a reason for that. He hasn't won in 2 years.
Maybe he remembers the feeling.
What feeling? Surprise?
No, they say when a horse wins, he remembers the feeling. And when the feeling comes back, he wants to win again.
You believe this guy? We're down 60 bucks, and he's looking for a horse with total recall. Okay, that's it. Come on. We're going with number five. 20 bucks. Let's go. Come on, get it up.
20 bucks, that's...
five apiece.
Five apiece? What are you going to do, buy the horse?
We're down 15 bucks apiece. If we win this one, we're even for the day, okay?
I'm in. I'll owe me a buck.
Yeah. $5?
If we win, you can send the fish on a cruise. Come on. Now listen to me. 20 to win on the five. The Flying Dutchman. You got it?
20 to win on the five. Yeah, I got it, George.
Oh, come on, come on. You got my shot. Let's go.
The horses are moving into line. Ready on top pole and Alan New. The flag is up. Now Khalife in the middle of the racetrack going for the early lead. Bailey is second on the inside flank. Dutchman races third. Orphan's Image is fourth. Ward C fifth. Khalife in sixth position. Top pole to seventh. And Alan New is the trailer. Moving down the backstretch. That's Al Khalife in front by one. Bay Letty charging up a closer second. Flying Dutchman still holds there. Dorfin's Image is fourth. Ward C and Calope. As the field turns for home, less than a quarter of a mile to go. Here comes Flying Dutchman on the outside to challenge. And down the stretch they come. Al Khalife in front by a hit. Flying Dutchman on the outside charging up. It's Flying Dutchman on the outside.
Oh, no. Tell me you got the ticket.
I got the ticket.
All right. Okay.
Tell me you bet 20 to win.
I bet 20 to win.
So what's the problem?
Well, there was this guy in front of me that was betting 300 on the two horse.
What does this guy have to do with our lives?
Well, I was thinking, since we were so undecided, and this guy was betting 300, I thought that...
Excuse me. Are we to believe, and I think we are, that you bet our 20 on the two horse?
Eat the ticket. Eat it.
What's he eat?
Two horse.
Oh, they're good. Hey, if that don't fill you up, you can wash it down with a tree.
This is Dick Canberg with sports. There was an old-fashioned brawl in Cleveland. Hey, a fly ball that hit the right field foul pole was called a home run by umpire Carl Hawthorne.
Come
when
on.
He pulled a fan
come on, work.
The ball.
Ow!
Hit the pole. Oh, my. Both benches clear.
Oh, my knob.
Cleveland Medical Center for observation. Final scores, in Cleveland 4-1, York top Chicago 3, and broke back to the left 2.
time.
They're in the garage.
Hey, troops.
Stump, what do you say?
Hey, Stump, hang on. We got a big thing going. Guy can make a fortune here.
What do you deal out the whole hand?
Any beer?
Showdown, and he's dealing one card at a time.
Right, it's in the tub.
You only get two apiece, so pace yourself.
Is that right? Would you rather have two good beers or four cheap ones and spend the whole night taking a leak? Huh?
Can you deal out the whole friggin' hand?
It's not how you do it, all right?
Guy could make three dimes here.
Hmm. Did you see that guy on the news last night? He won 200 grand in the lottery.
Yeah, but it's not steady.
You see, the guy bet his shoe size, 7.5. He bet 7, 1, 2.
Now I got 9D. I know I can't bet D, but I do know that it's the fourth letter of the alphabet. So I got 9-4. I'm still one number short. So what I do is I subtract 4 from 9. I get 5. Now I got 9, 4, 5. I'm going to give it a shot. What do you think? What's all this newspaper here?
Huh? Oh, Mads put it on. I don't want to get any water stains on the table, okay?
The toilet's running.
Duel, the toilet's running.
I heard.
There are people coming to look at the house. You gonna sit there and let the damn thing run?
Got one more card, Madge.
Your life is one more card. One more beer. One more belch.
Mm-hmm. All right. Pair of sixes.
All right.
Deuce. Nuts.
Duel, you got newspaper on your ass.
Huh?
Imagine one leaving the water stains on his chair.
The toilet.
What's it doing?
What do you think it's doing? It's sitting there running.
Probably that little chain. Got an extra hairpin you could wrap around there?
Not to spare. I got an even dozen. Maybe you'll hit it big tonight. Then I can pick up another dozen.
Can we get rid of this stuff for crying out? Like, get a blanket or something? I feel like a canary.
Okay, wait. Okay, we take the paper off, but don't get any water stains on this blue chip, baby. Madge will kill me, all right? All right.
Don't take that paper off that table!
She sees through walls.
It's the only broad I know has a change of life every day.
No. You just don't understand her. That's the prettiest little wee in the valley, boys. Just gotta know how to handle her. Watch this. Madge, could you bring us some potato chips, sweetie?
Who in Christ's name do you think you are? I am not waiting on no bunch of freeloaders. For 10 years, these bums have been coming over here. I've never known one of them to bring over a bag of chips.
She gonna get those chips or not?
Here are your built-ins, plenty of storage space. Can we have a look around back, please?
Sure, you can go out to the garage.
Great, follow me.
How long has this house been on the market?
Market. A little over a year, but we've had a lot of activity on it. We're talking Plum City. Hi, guys, don't let us interrupt. Well, this is your combination rec room and garage. With a little imagination and a couple of bucks, you could do a lot for this house.
Well, I suppose you could say that about any house.
Yeah, I suppose you could. But this is a perfect example of a house that could be something.
Does this house have a pool?
Pool? No, I'm afraid this isn't your typical pool neighborhood. You got to move uptown before you get into pools. No, ma'am, this is just a typical, nice, low, middle-class neighborhood. But if this isn't what you're looking for, I got a nice little cream puff and move-in condition right at the corner of Hudson and Ball. Oh!
Oh! Folks want a beer?
Oh!
Two beers. Dooley's in the can for an hour.
I hate watching football in this slop. You know, it kind of reminds me. It's a day like this that I lost the old lady.
How long's she been gone?
Who?
Did you ever see the headstone Mr. Sentimental over here sprung for?
Hey, come on, don't give me that again. That was a very expensive block.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure. When the guy carved her name on it, it was like writing on the head of a pin. Edna Shelton, a spark to light the room.
And she did, too. Boy, when she stuck that fork in a toaster, wham! She blew the toaster, her ticker, and 8 fuses.
When you gonna get married again?
Never. Wanna know why? All broads are the same. They won't let you touch them when you're going with them. They just keep telling you how good it's gonna be when you get married. So what do? You marry them. And I'll tell you something. It's nothing. It never gets any better.
So you ain't going up for the hair of the dog again, huh?
No.
A shame to take a catch like you off the market.
Open the door!
Hey, it's Lawrence of Arabia. What do you want?
Open the door!
We ain't got any.
Open the damn door.
Think it's gonna rain?
Yes, open the door.
Gee! Is it coming down out there?
Hey, you know what? Saw those guys, Tony and the guys, they're down there about 4 rows. You know what they're doing? They're cooking. They got a canvas over the tailgate, and they're cooking.
We should have thought of that.
Hey, what about the steaks? They ain't gonna hold up unless you cook them before the game.
Hey, you know, I was thinking, why don't I just fire up back here?
Hey, that's great. I'm starved.
Okay, but don't spill nothing.
Hey, guys, I got some hot stuff. Guess who I saw in the can, and guess what he told me? I saw Santiago.
Oh, yeah? What's the deal with Santiago?
Make my steaks rare, will you?
Yeah. Well, he's got a live one.
Oh, don't start. Another hot horse, huh? The last time I got a tip from one of them track guys, the horse started on Tuesday and finished on Thursday.
That's because he pulled a tendon.
Yeah, dragging his ass around the track.
Well, this is different, guys. Santiago's in on this one. He's got some stuff that he's going to give this long shot, and he says it can win by daylight.
Yeah? When's this horse go?
Oh, hey, you got a nipple.
Hey, dude, will you check that out? The thin ones cook just like that.
The horse goes on Wednesday in the second race. Now look, guys, here's where I figure. I say we all put in 50 big ones apiece.
This is the only stiff I know that calls a dollar a big one.
Santiago says that he gives this stuff to the horse will run from here to Detroit.
Why is he telling you about this?
Because I give him shoes. When I'm through peddling a line of shoes, I give him the samples. I always got a trunk full of those wingtips.
How many times have we sat around here moaning about getting in on this, getting in on that, and we don't? Maybe this is the big one. I say we put 100 apiece on this turkey and quit screwing around.
I don't know, that sounds like a lot of money.
What are you talking about? You're the one that brought up the idea.
Lou's right. Money talks, bullshit walks.
Right. Remember when we missed betting the Jets in the Super Bowl and Namath told us he was going to win it?
Didn't exactly tell us. He also told the world.
Yeah, but the point is we didn't take the tip.
That wasn't a tip. That was a freaking public announcement. This is a tip. Now, do we take it? Or do we sit around here talking about wet wool and playing with our meat?
Flip mine over. What are you doing?
I say we take it.
Stump's right. You don't want to turn down a good tip when it comes along.
What do you say, Wing Tips?
It sounds like a lot of money.
Well, I'll tell you what, I say we go to Santiago, and we say to him, look, if this horse is for real, we waltz right down the track and stick it to him. Let me put it this way. If this horse wins, you can tell Madge to take the card table, pink girls, and the toilet and stick him.
I'm in.
All we really need is...
You could have killed us.
Don't let the stink burn.
So what's the beef anyway, Madge? I sell shoes all week and smell feet all week. You'd want to get out too. So get it over, lady! You give them a car and they want the whole road. Oh. So, Madge, you go to the games, have a couple of beers, so what? You got a roof over your head, don't you? I'm home. I am home. I'm home. I am home. Boy.
Hmm.
I'm home.
Well, there's no place like Mom.
You want me to, look at the toilet?
Look at the toilet. Look at the chair. Look at the rug. It's your Mom.
Okay. What you reading?
The Weeders Digest. It's about a guy who sold shoes, made a fortune, retired, and spent the rest of his life just sitting around looking at his toilet.
I get it. I might have to shut this down for a while. Do you have to go?
I went yesterday.
Oh, you're lucky.
Don't smoke in my bedroom. You always smoke. It stinks up the place. You never have any consideration. And don't throw your butt in the toilet.
You've been using a lot of paper, man.
I don't know why you think you're handy all of a sudden. You're not a handy person. Your hands are weapons. My mother had your number, kiddo. Heartache and pain, that's all I've had from you. And broken toilets.
Last night at midnight, I got to call a plumber. Some clown calls himself the Dapper Crapper.
Morning. Say, Dooley, you don't happen to have a couple of bucks on you, do you?
Sure do.
Do sure. Hey, I'm telling you, those are faggy cigarettes. How many ball players you know that smoke a daisy?
All right. I smoke them because I bum them off Madge, and that's the only kind she buys, okay?
Did you ever hear of a guy making a touchdown, spiking the football, and saying to the rest of the guys, hey, this one's for the daisy?
Leave that Nikki Dixon broad.
What do you got, Toby?
I got rhythm.
Cute. Got any of these without fly shit on them?
No, we're all out of the clean ones.
One regular, one black, please.
$180.
Here, get yourself a lung.
Yes.
You come up with the 100 yet?
Nah, it's got the bank book hit again. She used to keep it in her drawers.
You mean you gotta look at her ass to get the bank book?
Dresser drawers. Boy, if she finds out I'm gonna take $100 out of the bank, man, big trouble. Mm.
Santiago. Hey, those are the worst looking pants I've ever seen.
They cover my nuts, don't they?
Santiago, What's the deal with this horse?
Look, you keep this under your hat, man. Not even nobody knows what we are doing. But I tell you, we got this horse, French Majesty. I'm gonna give him this stuff called Toluachi. And stand back, the pocket is gonna run. With the money we be making, I'll be down in Tijuana sucking down tequilas.
Wait a minute, wait a minute. What do you mean the money we making?
You gotta put a grand on for me, compadres.
A grand?
That's right. What do you think I do this for anyway?
What about the shoes I've been giving you?
Yeah, I've been meaning to talk to you about that. They the same foot. Don't you got any shoes for the right feet?
Well, they don't give you rights in the samples.
So, what's the deal? Are we in or off?
Okay, we're in. We'll make the bet for you.
Look, you give me my money and I make my own bet. That way, we keep things square. You're not looking at no dummy, you know?
He's right.
So, you bring me the money, and the horse will run like the breaking wind. I'll see you Wednesday, amigos.
Right.
Adios.
Tacos. Oh, you're right, man. This is big stuff.
You're not kidding.
Come on.
Oh, nice design, huh?
I beg your pardon?
I'm the one you decorated with the mud. Of course, that's okay. I was gonna plant flowers on my pants anyway.
See, with the manure on my pants, I got a pretty good chance of them growing.
Seems like a lot of fun.
Mm.
Excuse me.
I thought this place was gonna go topless.
Oh, no, you get a real bum crowd, Dan. You guys gonna run up a tab? You can put this on your Sears card.
Listen, I think we ought to forget about this whole thing. We are not in this kind of money league.
Oh, no, wait a minute. Maybe this is the big one. Do you remember Angie said we should buy that lot at the corner of Crosby and Sheridan, that they were going to put apartments there someday? We didn't do it, did we? And what's there? Crosby, Sheridan apartments. Now we got the inside...
I've been in those apartments.
Now we got the inside information on our shot that could really give us...
They are nice, man.
We're sitting here playing with ourselves.
I was in a two-bedroom once.
Plush. You know what I think? I think we ought to go to DeFranco.
Are you crazy? You're gonna hook us up with him? You're looking to get your kneecaps busted?
We're gonna hook up with him. We just borrow the money from him.
You're gonna borrow money, go to a bank.
Oh, that's good. Excuse me, I'd like to borrow $5,000 to lay on a horse. They're gonna shoot up in the second. Are you crazy? Look, you borrow the money for a couple of days, then we shoot it right back to him.
You know, what if the horse don't win?
Oh, no problem there. DeFranco shoots us.
You know, when Gigante tried to get Franco for that $20,000, you saw what happened to him, didn't you?
Wait a minute. I thought that was an accident. His car hit a pole.
A man ends up in the trunk of his own car with his ears stuffing in his mouth. That's some kind of an accident.
Look, here's the deal. Look, you get the money. Now, if the horse wins, then we just get the money, we take it back. Stop this. While I'm talking.
All right. I say we hit this thing as big as we can, and maybe for once we'll catch up with the rich bitches.
He's right. I am tired of sitting around waiting for crap to fall off the back of a truck so we can buy it at half price. I'm in. In.
In.
Ow!
Hey, that's 225.
The meter says two.
Yeah, but you listen to the music.
Here's for your music.
Yeah, go on, get lost.
You believe that creep wants another quarter for listening to his lousy tapes in the cab. Everybody's trying to suck every dime you got out of
you. Here you are, gentlemen. Right. Hope you have a very pleasant meal and the best of evenings.
You want a tip? Don't look directly into the sun.
Deliveries are in the rear, gentlemen.
It's all right. Just did the DeFranco's waiting for you. This
way. Dooley, boys, sit down.
Sit.
There we go.
You're all. Can you go over there? I just want to know.
Me?
Excuse
me.
Why don't you sit down?
Yeah.
Well, how you doing?
Fine, fine.
Good. It's good.
How's with you?
Great.
We're all fine. We're talking about it on the way over.
We're hanging in there.
I'm hanging in there also.
Good.
Yes, sir. Yep.
You boys want some calamari.
That's octopus, isn't it? Geez, I got a buddy. He says eating that stuff is like eating a bowl full of little plumber's helpers. What the hell does he know?
So what's the story?
We're interested in making a small loan for a short time.
How much?
5 big ones. Not big ones, like $5, but, how do you say 5,000?
5,000.
Right, that's 5,000. I didn't know the term.
That's a lot of green for guys in your league.
Well, that's why we're here.
This isn't anything the boss would be interested in, is it?
No, I don't think so.
Small potatoes.
Because, you know, sometimes some good comes down. Roscoe likes to get cut in on the action.
He does. Well, we're aware of that. But I don't think that this is honestly anything that Fusco would be interested in, because this is really, in a sense, not anything that he would be interested in, because he seems to be interested in larger deals.
Yeah, this is small peanuts.
I hate wobbling tables. I'll get it.
What is it?
Land. We're thinking of buying a lot up on Collins Point and putting in a hot dog stand. It would be small hot dogs and small buns. So you can see that Fusco wouldn't be interested in this because he's big hot dogs.
Duel, is that better?
And you want 5, huh?
5 big thousands.
It's gonna cost you. Here.
I need a matchbook.
10% of $5,000 is $800.
Excuse me. 10% of 5,000 is
800.
Right. We weren't carrying our one.
Is that too steep?
No. That's
fine.
Okay
to me.
Nice round figure.
When do you plan to get this money back?
Wednesday.
Oh.
Wednesday? That's an awful quick return.
Well, we're going to sell hot dogs on Tuesday, and then if they didn't go, then we would sell the hot dog stand and get the money right back to you.
All right. Sounds good. Mm-hmm. You decide, you come by, let me know.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Hey, Duel, check it now.
Stump.
Yeah.
I'm going.
Oh, boy, that guy really meant business. Yeah.
How about that interest, huh?
10% of $5,000 is $800.
Yeah, but who's going to argue with him? That guy could hit you so hard on top of the head, you'd have to unzip your fly to eat.
This is the third night in a row for this stew.
Me and the guys.
What the hell is with this meat?
Well, you get 2 of those, you get a prize.
I've got 3 of them. I could reconstruct the cow.
Anyway, we're going to pass me the salt.
Why? Are you sweating?
Just pass the salt. Anyway, we're going to invest in it.
You want a drop cloth?
Anyway, it looks like a great project. Any more bread?
In the freezer.
Freezer?
It makes a lot of sense, doesn't it? You buy a nice soft loaf of bread, you put it in the freezer. Then when you take it out of the freezer, you toast it so you can eat it.
You got
any frozen butter?
Anyway, as I said, this is going to cost a lot of money. And I'm not sure. I've got a good feeling about it. I'm going to break my teeth on this stuff.
Anyway, it seems like it's a proposition that I should go into, except I'm still a little shaky. Is that pudding?
Ooh, looks like pudding.
I just have a feeling that everything is going to be great. I just know that this is the thing, the one that's going to put us over the top, the big one. Empty.
Well, you have had quite a day.
Look, I got to decide something. Now, supposing you had a chance to make more money than you ever made in your whole life, say now or Wednesday, and you had to put up some really big money to do it, but you really weren't quite sure that it was going to work out, but you just felt that you just had to try it because you'd never taken advantage of anything like this before, and you felt, look, I got to this time. So you decided, what the hell, I'm going to go for it. But it was still a little iffy, but almost for sure. What would you do?
You got to get professional help.
Trainer Jude Felton.
Hey, Jelly. What's doing?
Hey, Mr. Dooley. Mr. Elton.
Losing weight?
Feeling good.
Where's Santiago?
I think he's in the can. You know them tamales go off about every half hour on him. But he be back.
Hey, French Majesty. When was this?
Oh, that was about 3 years ago at Thistle Down. That's the last time that old boy won. And he won that day for old Jelly. When you see me standing there in that red shirt yelling for him to hit the wire, he puts it in a high gear for old Jelly and won.
He's running Wednesday. You better get out the old red shirt.
Oh, no. I don't do that to the old Majesty. He ain't been the same since. And you see that red shirt and he break his heart to win for me. But them old legs of his ain't got that kind of tread left in them. No. Don't want him busting himself up for old Jelly. No, sir.
Swell.
Yeah. Ay, mamacita linda. Ay. Ay. Boy, these fucking shoes are killing my feet, man.
Forget about the shoes. We got to talk here, huh?
Talk, man.
Look, about the sure thing. We are thinking of getting some money from you. A certain party, and we expect a lot of heat to be coming with it, so we don't want anything to go wrong.
Look, all I know is a horse will be in front by daylight.
Does the jockey know about this daylight?
You guys put a couple of hundred on the nose for him, he'll ride till his ass falls off.
A couple of hundred for the jockey? What the hell is this?
Listen, when you guys give me the money, I give the horse this, and it's good night, Eileen. If this cheat don't work, I give you my hat to chew on. Come on, I'll show you.
You'll give us his hat to chew on?
You guys keep the balls of your eyes on the fence down there. Now, you see that I only put a pinch of this cheat in this carrot, man. I'll show you. Come on, Hilly Billy. Of course, with a horse, this cheat takes a little longer to work. But with this goat, you'll see what I mean. You see? You can put kerosene on that goat's tail. He won't run no faster than that.
Yeah, you may be right there, huh? Okay, look. We'll get you the money before the race, all right? Come on, you see that? Hey, Elton. It's a Nicky Dixon. Why don't you try to make a move on me? Oh, I was, I just checking to make sure they were even. Stirrups. You ride much?
Occasionally.
Well, like they say, once you've been in the saddle, you never forget it.
Is that what they say?
Maybe not.
Man. You believe that? She really is crazy about you.
Like I try to tell you, you know, these rich broads get kind of tired of those mint julep sucking tennis players. They start looking for a guy to give them a little variety, you know?
Oh, I see what you mean. She got enough steam coming off her to shave that goat.
Guys, we're playing with fire if we try to get the money from DeFranco.
Duel, I've been thinking. You could pull this off for us. All you gotta do is to waltz over to Miss Big Bucks and see if she'd been interested in giving us a little backup loan.
What are you talking about?
Nikki Dixon, the broad at the track. You say she got the hots for you.
Whoa, wait a minute. I'm not selling this body.
You mean that piece of shit is for sale?
Listen, you don't have to romance her. But just go to the loan window. Those rich broads love to tell the girls at the club how they lend 10 grand to some putts for no reason at all. And then maybe with a little wine, a little song, maybe you get lucky, though.
He may be able to do a little singing and a little sipping of the wine, but when it comes to women, his winky is retired.
Winky? Grown man calls the old joystick a winky?
Why can't you call your wizard a winky if you want?
Because it's stupid, that's why. Who besides him do you know that would call a dork a winky? Right?
Yeah, you call it what it is.
There, you see? What do you call it?
Monkey.
You're gonna get us this loan with a jug of wine, a loaf of bread, and a monkey?
Yeah. Have I ever let you guys down before?
Check.
Oh, no. You take this one.
Can I help you?
Do you have self-park here?
Not that I know of. Hey, are you with the band?
No, I'm not with the band. I'm here to see Miss Dixon.
Oh, hey, she's great. Listen, pal, don't worry. We're gonna take good care of your, car.
Great.
Looks like we might get some showers. You wanna put your window up?
Oh, all right, thanks.
Oh, gee, this is great. This is swell. This is a lot better than those glass windows you can see through.
All right. Do I need a ticket here or anything?
Oh, don't worry. I have a pretty good eye for matching up driver and car.
All right.
Yeah.
Good. Okay, just take care of it now.
Okay, mister.
Listen. First gear is busted on this. You got to put it in second, all right?
Okay. Yeah. Anything else?
No, that's all.
Hey, mister, it may get windy out. You better hold on to your hair.
Hope his face breaks out.
May I help you, sir?
Yes, I'd like to see a Ms. Dixon.
Yes. May I announce you?
I don't want anybody to. No.
No, I mean announce you to Ms. Dixon.
Oh, that was, yeah, go right ahead.
Yes. Who shall I say is calling, please?
Just tell her that the cigarette man is here. She'll... Oh, no. On second thought, tell her it's the guy from the track with mud on his pants and a wet cigarette. She'll know.
Good evening, Ms. Dixon. There's a gentleman here from the track with pants and a cigarette.
Mud. Mud on the pants.
Mud. Mud on the pants. And some cigarettes for you.
From her. Cigarettes are from her. It was wet from her, and I got... That's...
From you, I believe.
Oh. In that case, send him.
Thank you. She's in room 503.
Oh, thank you. What floor is that on?
Five. 503 is after 501 and 502. You see, the rooms are numbered in order.
Oh. Thank you very much.
Well, Mrs. Dixon must be getting desperate.
How you doing?
Doing.
I was just passing by, and so I told the guy to park the car. So he did.
What an amazing experience.
I think I got something you're going to be interested in. We're talking big bucks. I know you're big bucks, but we're also big bucks. I think you'd be interested in this.
Come in.
Yeah, well, I thought we'd give it a shot, so I just think. Pardon?
In. Come in.
All the way in. Boy, this is good. You got this by the day?
Here. I live here.
You live here? Every day?
Every day, Mr.
Oh, Dooley. This is a hotel, isn't it?
Dooley.
They get a little uptight about you hanging out of a room like this. I mean, don't they have to rent these things out? Of course, I guess your living here would be the same as renting the room out. So would you like a cigarette or anything?
No, thank you. I was just about to have a little repast, Dooley.
A what?
Snack.
Oh, yeah. Guess I could choke a little something down. So you have a few ponies, huh?
Oh, about 30 all over the country now.
30? Yeah, I don't have that many. Of course, not that I don't have that many. I don't have any. But I go to the track quite a bit, so I feel like I got them. You know what I mean?
Fondue.
What?
Fondue. The cheese.
Oh, fondue. Yeah.
Try one.
Oh, sure. Yeah, yeah. I try to get out there a couple of days a week at least, you know, and. What? What? Somebody really threw the heat to those babies, didn't they?
I'll be careful. Sandwich?
Oh. Thank you. Oh, you have a paint spill there?
Oh, that's a painting of my best stallion, Conduction.
Where?
Right there.
That's a horse?
It's two horses, actually. He's mounting a mare.
He's what?
An artist friend of mine painted it after watching Conduction in action.
Oh, yeah, I think I can see that. Now, that's some stud. Boy, no wonder you stay so thin.
Dolly!
What the hell is that?
Come on, behave.
Boy, between the dogs and the cheese, you really gotta be on your toes around here, don't you?
Care for more?
No, I... No, I'm jammy packed.
There's champagne. Would you open it?
Oh, sure. Thank you.
Are you married?
Married.
Yes, married.
Married. Why would you ask?
Some people are married. I was just wondering.
Well, I guess. Technically, we could say I am, but I'm not fanatic about it.
Well, you look a little inhibited.
Really? Inhibited? Me?
Oh!
Sorry, you must have got a hold of a bad bottle there.
Oh, that's okay. Gives me an excuse for slipping into something more comfortable, as the old cliche goes.
Say much. Get a cigarette, boy. Jeez. Geez. That's pretty. There was an accident. I think the dog took a crap.
Now, you wanted to talk business, so step into my office. This is where I do business, and you do want to do business, don't you?
I was hoping to.
Here, it's just a little something for you to slip into. You can change in the bedroom.
Swell. What I'd like to talk about is a loan.
Get in.
That's kind of nice.
You look like him.
Who?
My first.
First what?
My first man. My first love. He was a jockey.
A jockey?
Lyle Dorf.
Lyle Dorf?
He threw me over. Destroyed me. For another woman.
That's terrible. About the loan.
I searched everywhere after I got out of the sanitarium.
Sanitarium?
Every racetrack, every stable, wherever there were racehorses. I found you, Lyle.
Dooley.
I've waited a long time for this. I'll make sure you never cheat on me again.
I believe you have me mixed up with somebody else.
I'm gonna have my revenge at last, Lyle
Dorf. I'm beginning to wrinkle up pretty good here. I think I've soaked long enough.
I'm gonna geld you.
Are you crazy, lady?
Don't call me crazy. Don't call me crazy!
Your lady's crazy.
And it was your responsibility to get the car out of here because I gave you the keys. Hot day, huh? Boy, you're lucky she only scalped you.
Just get the car.
All right.
Look at that man. That's disgusting.
I wouldn't talk tuna legs.
So what did she do?
So then she comes at me with this knife.
You mean she tried to cut off your monkey?
Yeah.
You're lucky she didn't cut off your coconut too.
Yeah, I didn't know I was swimming with a lunatic.
Swell. Thanks to you, we gotta go to DeFranco for the money now.
I've been thinking, guys, maybe I should do the talking.
Forget it.
Not going up.
You got the eye of an eagle.
It's still not working.
What are you gonna give us, news updates? We can see it ain't working. There. Go. Wait a minute. Oh, there it goes.
We're gonna be late for our meeting.
I can see that. Will somebody please get out and grab that thing before it wrecks my car?
I can't get out. This
is gonna get
out.
Come on,
move. I don't believe
it. They are. Call somebody about this thing.
Up there, higher.
Grab it higher, too.
the door.
Oh. Hey, the window still works.
Roll it up. There's a draft here.
Oh, for Christ's sake, my car is ruined.
Why do we have to take off our shoes?
Because the sign says to.
I'm surprised they don't charge you to park your shoes.
Good morning, Mr. Fusco.
Hello, Mr. Fusco.
Mr. Fusco, I noticed a problem with the parking thing. I did have quite a bit of car damage in your parking lot. I put three quarters in the... I'm gonna catch him later on that thing.
May I help you?
Yes. We're here to see Mr. DeFranco.
Your names, please.
I just told him that Lou Dooley, Elton, and the Stumper here to see him. He'll know.
Mr. Lou, Mr. Elton, Mr. Dooley, and Mr. Stumper here to see you.
You don't have the money.
I'll get you the money, Mr. Fusco. If you just give me a couple more.
Right. Mr. DeFranco will see you now.
You better oil that couch. It's kind of squeaky.
Come in. Sit.
This is an awfully nice building Mr. Fusco has here.
The sign out there, the Fusco imports. What is it you import?
Lots of things.
That's good, because people need lots of things.
Leave go of the lamp. So... boys are gonna go into the hot dog business, huh? That's good.
Is that for us?
Right.
Thank you. Pardon me, there's no name on this. I was just wondering if,
It's for you. We don't ever make mistakes. It's all there. Just like I said, we don't make mistakes. You know, when you boys borrow money from Mr. Fusco, he expects that money to come back home. Kind of like the swallows coming back to Capistrano. You probably notice sometimes some of those swallows, they don't come back. It's because they got a busted wing or two.
I've noticed that.
Yeah, that's why I got a fish. Because he can't fall down in the water. I think he had a bruised fin one time, but I taped him up.
If you'll excuse us, we have to run along now. We still got hot dogs and buns to buy yet.
Thank you very much, Mr. Franco. We're... Now. Who's the horse?
That's one of Fusco's horses. It's called Ferretia, named it after his mother.
Yeah? Did she run here? I never heard of her.
His mother?
No, the horse.
Yeah, it raced once. Came in second, so Fusco had her destroyed.
Destroyed? You mean,
You boys play the ponies? Fusco's got a horse going Wednesday. He's odds on, so he's not going to pay very much. But you put a few bucks on it, at least you'll have one winner. Name is Papa Chippy. Gave it to his dad as a gift. Paid 150 grand for it.
Whoa, wow.
But it's running with a bunch of dogs, so should win by daylight.
Well, that's hey, great. Thank you.
Thanks a lot, Mr. Frank.
Thank you. Yeah. What race is that?
The second. Is the door locked?
No.
It's open.
Thanks a lot, Mr.
Thank you, sir.
See you.
Thank you very much.
Maybe we should do the hot dogs.
The second?
Yeah, the second.
You know something? If they had a contest for losers, the four of us would be tied for first place. How can you eat?
Because it could be the Last Supper.
Look, why don't we just give the dough back to DeFranco and forget about the whole thing?
Oh, sure.
And it costs us 800 bucks interest to look at 5 grand for 2 days. This whole friggin' deal's going right down the toilet. And I already got a brand new camper picked out and gonna buy.
Let's take a look at it.
What?
The money.
Jeez, I never seen that much in one lump before.
Oh, my God.
What?
10 here.
10 what? 10 big thousands.
You're kidding.
Don't start. It's 10. All right, what the hell is this all about?
It's bait. They know we're onto something hot. They figure we'll blow the whole thing. They're in for an extra 5. We owe another $800 interest.
Why don't guys like us ever get a break? I mean, how many books of tickets have we bought for St. Mary's? And who the hell wins a car? Some rich guy. He's got 9 cars in the garage already. I mean, why don't for once God say, let the peons win one?
Look, I don't want nothing, but these three losers could sure use a break.
I promise I'll try to get along with Madge.
If we win, I'll give half to the church. Maybe not half, but a sizable donation.
A new fishbowl for Ollie.
And a camper.
You guys gonna get anything?
I gotta remember to feed Ollie.
I gotta remember to feed Ollie.
I gotta remember to. Forgot to feed Ollie. I gotta feed Ollie. Feed him right now.
Hey. You don't! Look what you did! Ollie.
Oh, my God. Ollie.
You see this? You see what you did? Ollie! Oh, hold your breath. I'm coming. I'm going to save you, Ollie. Hold on. Ollie, you got to do something. You got to breathe. Come on, breathe. Like water, you gotta get to water. No. There you go. There you go. Water for Ollie. Here comes the water. There we go. Yeah. He's swimming now. Oh, see, it's like I'm telling you about life. You never know when you're gonna buy the big one. One minute you're swimming, and the next minute you're laying on a rug drowning. You're gonna be okay?
If we win today, I am gonna buy you a pond
and you will never, ever have to worry about falling out of the water again, I promise.
Here's your air hose. So, maybe I'll stick around anyway. Yeah, I think maybe I won't go out.
Huh?
Here's the driver.
The air hose on the fish tank busted. I had to fix it. Hey, don't worry, though. I got a shortcut.
The biggest day of our lives. And he's home pumping air to a 20-cent goldfish.
Yeah, I've been watching that fish for 11 years. I just can't let him breathe to death.
What's to watch?
All this thing does is waltz around the bowl, stirring up the shit at the bottom.
Where the hell are we? I thought you said you had a shortcut.
I do. We're almost there.
The track?
Shortcut.
Oh. Why would you screw around on a day like this? This is life or death to us. Look at what...
Can't you see the man is worried sick?
Oh. What's he worried about? We're gonna lose?
Don't.
Hey, let me look at the money again. Oh, boy, that's really big bread.
You think that's really big bread? If we win this thing at 40 to 1 with 10 grand bet on him, we're talking close to... really big.
At that. I paid $8 for those retreads and it's flat.
You got a spare tire?
You jerk. Why in the hell wouldn't you carry a spare?
For what?
Oh, I don't know. Might not be a bad idea at a time like this.
I have one. It's on a car already.
Well, great. We're all set. Let's pile in.
Oh, quit screwing around, will you? If we miss the second race, we're dead. I'll see if I can flag someone down.
Yeah, see if you can find a 73 Ford. Boy, there ought to be a ton of them going by at this hour.
Come on. Well, hitch a ride and leave this heap here.
Jeez, I hate to leave her out here like this. This car has driven us to 11 years of football games and racetrack.
Is everything you own 11 years old? The friggin' fish is 11. This car is 11. The lousy cheese dip you serve has got to be banging in 11 years now.
Hey, let's get this guy in the truck. Hey!
You.
Yeah, hey, right here. Yo. Hold it. Hold, buddy.
There. Just stay here, Kevin.
Be right back.
You boys got a problem?
Yeah, we got a flat one right around here, this right rear tire.
Yeah. Why, shoot. It's only flat there on the bottom.
You got a spare?
Stump? Man asked you a question?
No. No, I don't.
You don't have a spare?
No, I don't.
No spare, huh?
Nope, no spare.
This is worse than watching Stump's fish.
I say we bang him on the head and take the truck.
I really don't know what to tell you.
Which way are you heading?
I'm going down there to Falls View. I've got to pick up a couple of bales of metal sheeting for them gutters and run around my barn and hang down, you understand?
No, I've never seen your barn.
Well, it's a beautiful barn. I live about 3 or 4 miles this side in Stanton. You know that fruit stand? That boy sells two-day-old fruit?
And that boy with that odd eye, you know?
No, I don't know about the fruit stand either.
Say, I wonder if you could take us to the funeral home?
Funeral home?
Yeah. We had a buddy cash out on us here, and we were just on our way to pay our respects.
What funeral home? Where?
You know where the track is?
Racing track?
Right. As a matter of fact, you could drive us to Gate 5, and we could walk to the home from there.
It would mean a lot to our friend, and I'm sure it would the same to his wife. God rest his soul.
What are you saying? He's dead?
Oh, God.
It's a moment of prayer.
Oh, Lord.
Hey. We're wondering if you could drop us off at the home.
Yeah, I suppose I could, but would you do me a favor? I do have to stop off at Harmon's hardware store.
You do? We don't have the time for that. The opening prayer is at 1 o'clock, and we'd really like to be there for that.
Well, being it's you guys and all, and you're bogged down, yeah, I'll take you there.
Sit him in the bus, boys. You ride up front. He gets a little thick, so he's going to ride up front.
I forgot to lock the car.
Steal the damn thing.
Will you forget about the car? Who the heck wants a yellow bomb anyway? Look, if we don't get that track, you won't need it.
Now, do not pet the animal.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, he's bit a lot of paper. I ain't a kid.
Move it! Hey, all right, come on. Stop! Get in!
Want me to come along? Explain to the widow why you're late?
No, no, thanks anyway.
I could pay my own respects.
We'll tell her you sent them.
Come on, Captain. We're going up there to Weber's and get you a great big soup bone.
Okay, guys, we got 15 minutes to post, so let's get going, huh?
Hey, group. Nice outfits. Circus in town? Yeah. I see you brought your sister. How come you ain't home watching your fish?
I got a picture of myself. I leave by the bowl.
Hello, boys.
Hello, Mr. DeFranco. Oh, Mr. Fusco, how are you?
Good. Why? You know the lizard here?
Mr. Lizard?
Hey, Liz.
Miss Dixon here?
Yeah, yes. We go to the same health spa.
How's the wiener business?
Well, she tried to cut it off. It's good. The hot dogs are fine. We have some kids up there taking care of it now, and we're going to go up and check on them, you know. They steal you blind if you don't check on them.
I don't have that problem.
You know.
You boys ought to put a couple of bucks on Papa Chippy this race. And maybe you can afford to buy a new lining.
It's a nice color, green. You might want to take a little of that lining and put it on French Majesty. We understand that he has a possibility.
Is that what you understand? You're yodeling in a canyon, little man. Long shots are for suckers. Stick with the money. Papa Chippy wins by 20.
Catch you later. I hope the hot dog business works out, because we like to keep the books balanced, you know what I mean?
DeFranco, watch these people. They make me nervous.
Looks like Miss Big Bucks went for Mr. Big Bucks.
Good luck with his winky.
Yeah, you hear that? He says his horse is going to win by 20.
Why don't we take the money and put it on this Papa Chippy?
Will you shut up? I told you, we're going all the way with French Majesty.
I'm gonna puke again.
Okay, guys, here we go. 200 for the jockey. The rest goes on French Majesty to win. Got it?
Wait a minute. Gotta make sure that Santiago showed up. Dula and I'll go look for him. You guys wait here. We'll signal you if everything is okay. We gotta make sure that he's gonna give the horse his
shoes. Yeah, he's got new shoes.
The new shoes.
The horse needs new shoes.
They've been killing him.
Haven't they, no?
Watch for us.
Hmm?
Hey.
You see him?
No.
What if that creep didn't show up?
Hey! There he is.
Aye, these shoes.
Where'd you been, man?
We had a long day, okay? All right.
You got the money?
Yeah. You got the stuff?
Not to worry. I'll see you in the winner's circle. I tell the jockey you place the bet, right?
Right. Okay.
that way.
Jock's agent.
Right. Where's Elton?
He's still making the bets.
Good. Okay, so we relax. That's it.
Do you know Lyle Dorf?
No.
You look like him. Maybe we could get together after the races and I'll tell you all about it in my office.
Sounds good.
Hey, Josh, what do you got?
Like I told you, Papa Chippy.
Kidding, huh?
What about French Majesty?
Well, how you want to bet him? To live?
What are you talking about? We think he's got a chance.
So did General Custer, pal.
Oh, really? Yeah, come here, wise guy. Look, want to tell him?
If he can keep his mouth shut.
Okay. Come here. Listen, we got some hot stuff. Santiago says his French Majesty can really move.
Santiago, that weasel. He's a Connoroo.
What are you talking about?
Well, he used to tell guys that he could make horses take off, you know, so he'd get like a cat. Give your cat a little piece of meat with a lot of chili sauce on it, and the cat would take off like a jet plane. So Santiago say, I can do the same thing for horses. Of course, he can't. What he can do is take your money and then give you some lame excuse when a horse goes into the toilet. He's a dip. I think I'm gonna go get a beer, guys.
We've been had.
Elton! We gotta stop him from betting! Elton! We gotta stop him! Stop!
Take the stairs. You go that way.
Albert! Oh. Hey, Albert!
The horses have reached the starting gate.
Excuse me, sir. Excuse me. Have you seen our friend? He's the... Oh, excuse me. Two, three.
Help! Help!
Oh,
I'm sorry. Sorry. Hackman? It's a lucky toilet we're...
Seven to win.
Here at the post.
Albert!
They put cowlips in these things.
That's right, cowlips. Think about it.
Albert!
What?
The money! The money!
Did you bet the money?
The tickets!
Huh?
It's okay. Relax, you guys. I got the tickets.
Oh, no. It's a setup. It ain't a fixed race. We've been had.
A flank is on.
I'm gonna puke.
Oh.
Hey! In the center of the track, that's number six, Caprizo, going for the early lead. Brookside Dream in second. War Hostess is third. Then comes Papa Chippy in fourth. River Code is next. Joe Benetti and French Majesty is the trailer. Moving down the back stretch, it's Caprizo showing away by a length of three quarters.
What's wrong with Papa Chippy?
Nothing. Papa Chippy knows when to make his move.
Oh, my God.
I'm gonna kill myself.
Well, Fusco will handle that for you.
As they move to the top of the stretch, Brookside Dream takes the lead.
When he sees me standing there in that red shirt yelling for him to hit the wire, he puts it in the high gear for old Jelly.
Richard, for the horse.
What?
Richard!
That's right, give me
the Richard!
Horse!
What are you talking about?
Where are you going?
Thank you.
Who got it?
It looked like Pompey Chippy to me.
Oh, what the hell do you know? Who got it? Who got it? Did you see? Who got it?
Hey, look, guys, just a couple of minutes till we find out who won, huh?
Come on, move it.
You're hurting my arm.
Hey, don't hurt my friend.
Hey! Is anybody out there? Hey!
What?
Can you hear me?
What do you want?
Hey, who won the second race?
What are you in for?
I'm not in for nothing. Who won the second race?
I hope you're fried.
Boy, they sure don't make people like they used to.
Can you imagine that?
Fried.
Duel, I want you to know that if Fusco comes after you, he's gonna have to go through me first.
Thanks. Appreciate that.
If something does happen to me, though, would you look after my fish?
Yeah.
Thanks, Duel.
Okay, let's go. We were out?
That's right. Your buddy's posted bail.
Whoa, huh?
Hey, you wouldn't happen to know who won the second race, would you?
Check for the information.
If you got two ones, I'll give you five. We need to change.
I ain't got it. You're busted.
Yeah. Get these two clowns out of here. I'll see you on the 14th.
They were busted.
Rat busted.
Hey, guys, I'm sorry. I thought we had a shot at a piece of the pie, and I really...
Hey, don't worry about it. Maybe Fusco will lighten up for one time.
No chance. One of his hoods gave Elton such a chop in the ribs you won't believe, just as a preview.
Really?
Show them out.